Yo, what up? It's Will Maker. Today I'm going to go over part two of my restoration series. So with that, let's go ahead and dive in. If you missed the first video, I went over badly recorded vocals, hiss, reverb, missing some high-end frequencies, and you can check that out here. In the second part of my three-part series, I'm going to go over how to fix a clipped vocal and what you can do to remove electrical hum. What's the difference between hum and noise? Noise is background noise, hiss, etc. Hum is a low tone produced by electrical interference. DeHum is a plugin that can remove hum. And if you have ground issues in a recording, a hum or a buzz, try using DeHum. I find RX's DeHum to be the simplest for me. Thankfully, I don't run into this issue much, but I thought I'd add it. So here, I have a hum. The first thing that I'm going to do is change my filter type to static, and then I'll just play the tone and hit learn. Nice and simple. Now what you can do is the remaining noise that we have is noise, so we can add our denoise plugin. Go ahead and click on learn, which normally I would do during the most silent part because I don't want it to really alter my actual source vocal or whatever it is I'm trying to take out the noise. But this is just the example. Turn it on. And here is where you can reduce it. So anything below the reduction line won't play. Simple as that. The next issue is going to be a clipped recording, and if you're recording with a 32-bit float sample rate, you won't have to worry about this. But if you're dealing with recordings that are recorded with any other sample rate, you can potentially deal with clipping and distortion. And using a DeClip plugin can be very helpful. You might have trouble knowing your recording is clipped. I can usually tell if my recording is clipped by three things. You have a square shaved waveform, or the recording might sound a little distorted or fuzzy in parts, and three, it's always loud. You're gonna have a hard time setting a level when you're trying to mix it when a recording is severely clipped because it's always loud. So no matter how much you lower it, you can try and EQ and compress all you want, but this will not fix it. It's ideal to record a performance over again, but when you don't have that option, thankfully we have a DeClipper. So what this does is estimate the signal's curve and also the range of where the signal is not clipped, kind of reshaping your clipped waveform. So let's go ahead and check out the interface. So as you look at the waveform, you can see it's very square at the top, which is an indication that it's been clipped. Now, as we listen to the recording, we'll be able to hear that.
Baseball caps, t-shirts, and gym hats, low-hung jeans, rhyme books, and backpacks.
I don't want to add the DeClip plugin in my vocal chain, so I'm going to launch it from Audio Suite and then render it. You can set your threshold to where you want your audio to begin processing, and you have a detect button that'll help you put yourself in a good spot, and you can make adjustments. So let's look and listen to see how this is done.
Baseball caps, t-shirts, and gym hats, low-hung jeans, rhyme books, and backpacks, acting...
You can see right here where the line breaks, that's where we're going to set our threshold. You also have an input and an output and a quality knob, which this I turn all the way up. I choose to render this because if I don't, it's going to cause a lot of latency. And I choose to render the sections that are clipped so I can leave the non-clipped portion of the wave untouched. So I'll start right here and I'll render this. And as you see, the waveform's changed. So I'm just going to repair all the parts that are clipped in this waveform. So we'll take a listen now.
Baseball caps, t-shirts, and gym hats, low-hung jeans, rhyme books, and backpacks.
And this is before.
Baseball caps, t-shirts, and gym hats, low-hung jeans, rhyme books, and backpacks.
And again with the repairs.
Baseball caps, t-shirts, and gym hats, low-hung jeans, rhyme books, and back.
This portion still looks clipped, so I'm going to repair this a little more. And I'll just try and process this a little more.
Rob.
And I'll render it again. And now I'll listen.
T-shirts and gym hats, low-hung jeans, rhyme books, and backpacks.
Sounds a lot better considering the severity of the clipping. Lastly, if you're looking to remove some crackles or your mic gets bumped during the recording, we have a DeClip plugin. So let's take a listen. So here you have crackle, click, plosives, and thumps. You can turn on or off each one, your sensitivity knobs here. Click expand applies the amount of smoothing to the click detection signal. Click time and skew is the shape of the click. Plosive and thump cutoff is the frequency limit. So you have 20 to 350 hertz. So as an example of a plosive, that's our plosive. That's what you're going to be listening for.
Learning from my past to make me.
So that P really pops out. So if you're looking for the cleanest mix, that P can definitely stand out. So here's basically what we're going to do to address it. So we'll take a listen. So now that I got that sounding a lot smoother, now I can just render it. And let's go ahead and take a listen.
Learning from my past to make me.
And here's before.
Learning from my past to make.
And after once again, and you can see that the P has gone down significantly.
Learning from my past to make me.
I did also pull this from the audio suite dropdown, so that way I can just fix the word and I don't have to put this in my vocal chain. So that's how I use DeHum and DeClip plugins. This is also how I address any electrical noises in my recordings, clipped vocals, little thumps, and crackles. Keep in mind your quality will be greater the less intense your settings are with the plugins. The higher the setting, the more damage you can do to your track, and it will end up sounding lifeless. And if you like content like this, please feel free and like and subscribe. Other than that, peace out.